I actually forgot that you were coming in today for me to do your makeup. So I woke up and I quickly slapped on this masterpiece and came down. You may notice that I look a little different to usual. I learned some new techniques for doing my makeup, contouring and filling in my eyebrows more obvious. And of course I still have the lip, but I try not to overline as much as I used to, because, you know, like I always say, I don't want to look too unnatural. Okay. Okay. So, oh my goodness. Excuse the hair, excuse everything. You know, I can't help but look in every reflective surface at myself, because I look really good with this new makeup look. I've been watching a few YouTube videos for some tips, you know, and I really, really like the results. So, definitely going to keep doing it, okay? What do you think? I look like a different person, I know. Yes, okay. Alright. You, on the other hand, we are hoping to make you look like a different person. Yes? Okay. First, we start with a base, obviously. Always want to start with a base. Now, I usually go, like I said before, when I did your makeup, I think that I like to go a few shades darker. I have done again, but it's not quite as noticeable as usual, because I think I've got a really, really good tan. Look at this. Look how dark I am. Okay. So, first things first, I'm going to use this on you. This is what I used on myself. Not this particular one. It's just that. Okay, yes, I use this particular one, but you know, they're also. It's fine, you know, it's not all dried up or crunchy like it looks. It is absolutely fine. Okay, so just chill out, okay? Calm down, you really. Don't need to worry about anything. Okay. So, I discovered something as well. This BB sponge thing. What is it? Beauty blender? Blendish? Blending? Blender. Beauty blender. That's correct, or is it like, I don't know, but anyway, I got this, and it is so good. You need to excuse me, I had a lot of caffeine, because I literally just downed about 3 cups of coffee. I'm starting to really feel it kick into my soul, you know, it's really awakening me. So let me explain the beauty blender, okay, to you. Okay, should be called the sexy sponge. Okay, right, so basically what you do, what I do is I put the foundation on my hand. Okay, and then I pop it into place, so run. Look how nicely that pretty much matches my really, really exotic skin tone that I have, this For some reason, I just seem to have woke up and been really tanned. I mean, can't you tell? It's practically blending in. So, and then I kind of tap it around, put it in spots on the face. Okay, and then, so basically, I explain difference. So this is for, well, it's weird because I hardly ever use this side anymore, but this is the flat side, so that you just pack in your color. It's okay to share sponges, it's absolutely fine. I mean, look at my skin. Does it look like it's carrying disease? No, no worries. Okay. So, basically, what I do is, what I will do for you, just to show you how it works, is I am going to just pack on the color with the flat side first. With the Beauty Blender, it's a bit of a, I don't know, blending. I always think blending, because you know when you blend eyeshadow, not like I do eyeshadow really, that you blend, you know, you're really trying to blend. But with the Beauty Blender, or maybe it should be called the Sexy Stippler. But anyway, you just tap, okay? You just tap the foundation into place. I like to tap quite fast to really get that in there. Get all those flat, big flat surface. You have lots of big flat surface on your face. Then we basically turn it over, and we have little side here. This little bit here gets into all your crevices, into your eyes, and into around your nose. If you got big chin, you know, like yours, you just go right into the bum, and so you get right under there. But I like to actually, instead of using flat side, I like to just use round edge to blend. I find that works really well. And then this for the little bits, okay? Just like that. And then little. It's like an egg. It's like an, you know, on the packaging when I bought it, it said replace every 1 to 3 months. This thing is going to last me a year, and I doubt in that time I'll even wash it, because why not? Or why should I should say. Why should I? I mean, my germs are my germs. You know, I wash my face, I wash my hands. I had a lisp there for some really weird reason. I wash my face and my hands. What could possibly go wrong? Unless you didn't wash your face. Okay, fine, I believe you. Then you want to get down here. Get all around your nose. And I'm just going to go over your face to blend even better with this side. You want a really nice, natural base. Don't forget to blend in the chin, because you don't want to look ridiculous. Now I swipe it a little bit just to get the blending in here. But that's the only swiping I do. Okay. Right, now let me get rid of the excess of my hand. This is my really clean tissue. That's probably too small a bit of tissue, actually. We'll fix that later. Okay. So now I'm going to powder. Oh no, not I'm going to conceal, because you look like you've had a hard night. Me, I didn't need to put any concealer on. So this one I just dab as well. That wasn't a demonstration, that was me itching my cheek, but not wanting to ruin my makeup. Okay. And this I blend in with my finger, because now the beauty blender is good when you have the little end, but when you try to get in there, sponge blind your eye. So it is too invasive. I like to just use my finger, the little one. No, that's my second to littlest. My ring finger, not like there'll ever be a ring on there. It's not sad, for God's sake. I love being alone and lonely. And yeah. Just dab it, because this is, it has the lightest pressure. Okay. Beautiful. Right, what do I want now? I've lost everything. My mind is... Oh, I can feel the vibrations in my brain from the caffeine. Okay. So, now, what I'm going to do is to basically... I'm going to powder first, then the real art begins. Okay. So. Oh, I've got pockets in this dressing gown. I just put brushes in there. Good idea. Okay. So. Little powder. You can use loose powder, or you can use the compact. I use the compact, but sometimes when I get to really small, I crush it up, put it in pot, and use it like that. So, basically, what I want to do is to see, I've used quite a lot of it in the middle there. Comes off really well, actually. And then I use, it's in my pocket and I forgot about it already. I use a flat, one of these little things. So, one of them's really compact flat brushes with a really nice handle. You know, these can retail for so much, but I just got cheap ones off, you know, like online somewhere. Because who cares at the end of the day, they'll do the same thing. Oh, look how clean it looks on the inside. The only thing is cleaning these bad boys are such a nightmare. It is ridiculous to get in there. Really, really difficult, so... Just be warned if you get one of these little thingies. Okay, so... What we're going to do... Is just really... We want a lot of that, okay, because... I can practically see your pores expelling grease. Okay. So. Again, I tap it on your face. Really getting hard on forehead there. Oh, and your nose. Okay. Basically everywhere. To do under my eyes, I just get one swipe, dab it, another swipe, dab it, because I find that gets in there really nicely. Close eyes. You know, I think it just makes that bit, because I don't like the shiny under eye, so that is what I do for that. A little bit too crazy. Okay, so then we want blusher. want lots of pleasure. It is the sign of health and rejuvenation, rejuver, whatever. So I just used the cheapest one I could find because it's, who cares? And it's nice and bright and like so. Now this is just a matte blush. It not shine, doesn't shine, not shiny at all, because I'm not a fan of all the razzle dazzle. I like my face to be flat. apart from my lips, nice and juicy. Okay, so the brush I use for this is just a standard blusher. come with free foundation on there. See, it says blusher. Okay, loads of these. Oh yes, just go crazy with this. Okay, smile a little bit so I know I've captured the apples. Yeah, that is good. You have such huge cheeks. Okay. That is not necessarily a bad thing, so don't worry. Now this is where my new skill comes in handy. Look how small my nose looks, look how chiseled my cheeks look. Okay, I will let you become as chiseled as me. What we have here is crappy palette. Look, I'm missing some blushes and things, but all you need is this section here. Now you pick whatever color you want. I go for this one and a mixture of this one. And what brush we want is finger. I just use my finger, so I'm just going to get it into one of these, okay? Beautiful, that is the amount you want. I'm going to start with your nose. There's a hair on me. Oh my goodness. Alright, now I'm going to go under here as well. Now, little brush, compact, it's very compact as well actually, but that's more of a normal one. Okay, and I'm just going to blend. To concentrate. Underneath. Blending is quite difficult because it really stays there, but now that we've blended, we've created a smoky nose. You know, you have smoky eyes, we have smoky nose. And now we want to Great, because you can see I have harsh, but we like that. We want to recreate that. So I take more and I just go. Okay, hold on. Two hands on this bad boy, okay. So we just. Get some more. And now with this one, the cheeks. I did blend this, I didn't want a harsh line. So, what you can do as well, if you have more than one chin, is to contour here, but I don't, I'm chiseled anyway, so. But I think I'll do that for you, okay? So, that one. And we just want to. Well, you don't really need to, I'm a pro, I can find. But you know, people with fatter faces, it's harder. That's oh, amazing. Late night snack packages there. So beautiful. So much so that I don't need to do your double chin. Okay. Right. What else did I do to my face this morning? Eyebrows. That's another thing I learned. And do you know what? People use eyebrow pencil. Not me. I use waterproof eyeliner in black. Who cares? Close enough, don't you think? And it's just crazy the lengths people go to, you know. Okay, so just need to. Oh well, they're sisters, not twins. Okay. And also, cool thing about this is it has sponge to blend, because obviously you blend eyeliner. Why not blend eyebrows? You know? And then just a little splash of this. Because I have naturally stunning eyes. I don't ever feel like I need to. You can create your own dimple. Have you ever thought of that? Anyway, just going on tangents. So, literally, I'm going to do the littlest bit because we don't need a lot. Not for the main event. Well, not really. I think the contour is my new thing now, but lips. No, like I said earlier, I'm going more natural. So, I've got my lip pen crayon. Well, it's crayon, not pencil. That is broken, but it is still fine. It's lovely and pigmented. Like a lot of people go on about that, don't they? Pigment, whatever. So, I'm just going to draw ever so slightly out of your lip line. And I watched one YouTube video, they said, never outline the lower lip, like never go outside the line. Personally, pish posh, you know, do what you want. If you want your lips to look massive, you do it. So much to fill in because I just went crazy. But you know, you do have little like French fry lips, so. Whereas I have, you know, thick cut chips, that kind of thing. You know, you just got to work with what you have. So. So proud of how you look. I don't know. Not as good as me, but you look, you know. And then if you want to look like me, you just mess up your hair completely, put a dressing gown on, and just look amazing. And I'm probably going to go to bed after this. You know, I mean, I'm not even supposed to be up yet at this time in the morning. It's okay, well, it's midday, but what are you going to do about it? Okay. Oh dear, it's not funny. Okay. Thank you for coming back to see me. It has been lovely as always. Just make sure that you don't come next time until about 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Okay. Thank you, because otherwise, you know, I'm just not gonna bother coming out. So what I'm going to do now, put the old hood back on. And I'm going to leave. Nice seeing you. Thank you. Don't let the door hit you on the behind on the way out. Okay. Yep, lovely. Okay, see you later. Don't touch any of my stuff. Just leave. Thanks. Bye. God damn it.